Welcome back. We discuss in this lesson least square estimates of LSD, Latin square design. What is meant by least squares? By using principle of least squares, estimates, we have to estimate the parameters mu, alpha I, beta j, gamma k, and then epsilon I, z, k. So these are the parameters are going to be estimated by using principle of least squares. It's nothing but least square estimates of Latin square result. So now I consider we have to use the principle of least squares for minimizing some of the squares of the residuals. So write some of the squares of the residuals. The residual sum of squares epsilon I j k is equal to. So y is equal to some mathematical model we have. From that we calculate epsilon is k. So it is nothing but summation I j k belongs to S. It is y is k minus mu minus alpha I minus beta j minus gamma k. This is what the residual sum of squares. This is what residual epsilon is k is equal to the deviation. Deviation from y is a k minus mu alpha I beta j gamma k. So this is what called sum of the squares of the residual. Sum of the squares of the residual sum of squares. This is sum of squares residuals. Right? Fine. So now by using the principle of least squares, the parameter mu is going to be estimated by dou e by dou mu is equal to 0. Now differentiate it and show that equal to 0 with respect to mu. Right? So therefore it is nothing but, for example, f of x whole square 2 into summation I j k belongs to S y I j k minus mu minus alpha I minus beta j minus gamma k multiplied by the differentiation for minus mu is equivalent to minus 1 is equal to 0. Differentiation for y is a k minus mu, y is a k 0 with respect to mu, minus mu is minus 1, minus alpha I, minus beta j, minus gamma k. Constants, differentiation becomes 0 with respect to mu. So therefore, I am expanding 2 cannot be 0, minus 1 cannot be 0. So therefore, this particular term, summation, I am expanding. So summation I j k belongs to S. This is y is a k minus, you see here, I write here and I reduce the steps. Summation I j k belongs to S, it is mu. Summation mu is a constant, does not depend on summation I, summation j, summation k. On three summation does not depend, it's a constant purely. Now, how many values are there? N square. Not three summations therefore. Not three values, m cube values, m square into mu. Why? Because we have only m square values. So if you first take I summation I and then summation j, finish. The values are finished. Okay? So that is the intensive and the meaning you have to consider. The deep meaning and that particular summation. While considering the summation, you have to consider m square. So now here summation, you see here whatever the summation you have. Alpha I does not depend on summation j, summation k. So hence I am taking m values outside. Summation I is equal to 1 to m alpha I. Why? Because summation with respect to I is there still. If you take two summations outside even then, but we have only m terms here we have. That is what my intention to specify very clearly. See here also m into summation j is equal to 1 to m beta j. Here also minus m into summation k is equal to 1 to m gamma k is equal to 0. Summation, you know that as far as your knowledge is concerned, I have given the formulas. Summation I alpha I is equal to 0. Summation j is equal to 1 to m beta j is equal to 0. Similarly, summation k is equal to 1 to m gamma k is also 0. These are the terms which are zeros. We have calculated in two-way classification. Summation I alpha is 0, summation j beta j is 0. Similarly, summation k gamma k is also 0. Therefore, this is 0, this is 0, this is 0. So, only the terms, two terms we have here. And I am taking one particular term right hand side. That is m square mu is equal to summation I J K belongs to S. It is Y I J K. Summation Y I J K belongs to S. So therefore, the final value of this. What is the final value of this? After doing this, the end value of this. Therefore, mu is equal to 1 by m square summation I J K belongs to S. Y is a k. This is what the term we have. What is this? This is the formula of y bar dot dot dot. Three summations are running. So therefore, it is the formula of overall mean y bar dot dot dot. Three summations are running. I J K. So therefore, y bar dot dot dot. So that is therefore mu is going to be estimated by mu cron is equal to y bar dot dot dot. This is what the estimation of mu. Have you understand this? The first estimation of the parameter, estimating the parameter mu, mu cron is equal to y bar dot dot dot. This is the one such result. Next step. The parameter alpha I. Have you considered the parameter alpha I? Now, if you consider the parameter alpha I, differentiate with respect to alpha I. That is rho e by rho alpha I is equivalent to 0, which implies differentiate with respect to alpha I. If you differentiate with respect to alpha I, you have to first of all expand the summation with respect to I. I is equal to 1 to m, or the terms that I is equal to 1. The term consists of alpha 1. I am discussing about alpha 1. That is y I j k, y 1 j k, minus mu, minus alpha 1, minus beta j, minus gamma k. Alpha 1 term is there. Differentiation becomes 0. I is equal to 2. Y 2 j k minus mu minus alpha 2 minus beta j minus gamma k with alpha 2. There is no I. Differentiation term becomes 0. Similarly, I is equal to I. The differentiation is only for that particular term. I is equal to I. Remaining term differentiation becomes 0. Which means in E, after expanding that, we have only summation j k. I is expanded. I is expanded. I is equal to 1, 2 and so on. M expanded. In which we are differentiating all the terms. Ith term is also only going to differentiate remaining terms. The differentiation becomes 0. That is what my explanation. So remaining terms differentiation becomes 0. So therefore, now we have 2 into summation j comma k belongs to S. It is y I j k minus mu minus alpha I minus beta j minus gamma k multiplied by minus 1 is equal to 0. What is the differentiation for yij with respect to alpha I? Differentiation becomes 0. Minus mu is 0. Minus alpha I, differentiation is minus 1. Minus beta j, minus gamma k, differentiation is 0. Right? So that is what the differentiation now you left. So now we expand the summation. Summation jk belongs to S yijk. That is the first term. If we expand with respect to jk, I, the term finished. Now you see, summation j k belongs to S, belongs to S. We need not consider always belongs to S. I j k only if we consider belongs to S, that's enough. Summation j k I have considered. You need not consider again and again, right? So summation j k, this is what mu minus summation j k alpha I. J k alpha I minus summation j beta j. So I'm writing summation j beta j. This is minus summation k gamma k. Minus summation k is equal to 1 to m gamma k is equal to 0. Now you remember why here we have summation, I have expanded summation j. Summation j and k, two terms, two summations we have. But whenever you have considered like this, then you have to multiply with m, isn't it? But why I did not multiply with m? Because already we have expanded the summation I is equal to 1 to m terms are finished. There were only m terms are there. So that is the reason here we have m terms. Summation, if you take summation j, because beta j depends on summation j, the j is equal to 1 to m terms we are using here. Already we have used m terms. So therefore, if you use summation k also, that's no use. So no other term remains. So therefore, this no m should not multiply. There is no m, again one more m is not there. So therefore, so summation j beta j is 0, summation k comma k is 0. So therefore these two terms are zeros. right? Remaining terms summation j comma k with yijk minus summation j comma k mu. Now you see here, this is very clear explanation. Mu is a constant, does not depend on both summation j and k. But we don't have m square. J m terms we have, k m terms we have. But there are no m square terms. Here no m square terms because already I is equal to 1 continuum, which was expanded, which was considered ith term. We have differentiated after expanding I is equal to 1 to m, then only we have differentiated the terms. So we have only m terms of mu. This is what you have to get crucial. If you confused for m square, then if you write m square, there is no meaning for that because already we have expanded I is equal to 1 times 1 m. That is what my mean, right? So and then this is summation again here alpha I is equal to alpha I does not depend on summation jk. So hence it is constant. But m into alpha I, not for j is equal to 1 to m, k is equal to 1 to m, not m square, only m. Because I is equal to 1 to m, and so on, m was already expanded. So is equal to 0. So that is what. Now you have to calculate alpha I. If you have to, now you have to calculate alpha I. So calculate alpha I. So if I got writing m into alpha I right hand side and then remaining comes here summation j comma k yijk minus mu divided with m, then alpha I is equal to, then alpha I is equal to 1 by m into summation j comma k yijk minus mu. M is get cancelled. What is this? Summation j comma k is which of running yijk divided by m. So it's a mean. Mean of what? Mean of ith value jk running, then therefore I dot dot y bar I dot dot minus mu. This is what alpha I. So therefore, by estimating alpha I cron is equal to y bar I dot dot minus mu cron. So answer is y bar I dot dot minus y bar dot dot dot. That is what the formula of alpha I cron. So similarly, we can try to calculate beta j and gamma k. Okay, similarly we get the same beta j values. Beta j cron is can be obtained as y bar dot j dot minus y bar dot dot dot, and gamma k is going to be obtained as y bar dot dot k minus y bar dot dot dot. This is what the two other particular parameters are going to be estimated by simply taking dou e by dou beta j. Beta j is equal to 0, which implies you will get beta j cron is equal to y bar dot j dot minus y bar dot dot dot. This is what the term you will get. And similarly, by taking dou e by dou gamma k is equal to 0, by differentiating this with gamma k, we will get gamma k cron is equal to y bar dot dot k minus y bar dot dot dot. These are the estimations of the parameters mu, alpha I, beta j and gamma k. Now you have to estimate epsilon I j k. Now you have to calculate or estimate epsilon I j k. That's what I calculate now. Epsilon I j k, by taking all these values, I calculate epsilon I j k. What is epsilon I j k? Epsilon I j k is equal to, it is y I j k minus mu, that is mu cron I consider, alpha I minus beta j cron, that is gamma k cron. So which is y I j k minus mu is estimated by y bar dot dot dot, and alpha I y bar I dot dot minus y bar dot 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 minus beta j minus y bar dot j dot minus y bar dot dot dot. गामा के माइनस वाई बार डॉट डॉट के माइनस वाई बार डॉट 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 दिस इज व्हाट वी हैव द टर्म्स हियर सो नाउ नाउ यू कैन इजीली अंडरस्टैंड व्हाई माय व्हाई 2 इनटू वाई बार डॉट डॉट सो हियर यू सी हियर वाई इज ए के माइनस वाई बार आई डॉट डॉट माइनस वाई बार डॉट जे डॉट माइनस वाई बार डॉट डॉट के y bar i dot dot y bar dot j dot y bar dot dot the other than here minus y bar dot dot minus of minus plus y bar dot dot will get cancelled so minus of minus plus y bar dot dot minus of minus plus y bar dot dot it is plus 2 into y bar dot 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 this is what the epsilon is taking so this is the where this is what the term y is ak minus y bar i dot dot minus y bar dot j dot minus y bar dot dot k plus 2 into y bar dot 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 it is the term we have observed there summation is ak belongs to s sir sse sum of the squares due to the error is equal to summation is ak belongs to s sir y is ak minus y bar i dot dot minus y bar dot j dot minus y bar dot 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 plus 2 into dot k plus 2 into y bar dot 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 whole square so this is what the term we have obtained here by epsilon I say k so this is what the least square estimates of that is square of length hope you understand thank you